أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط صدق الله العظيم.
من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء لله Oh you who believe stand up to establish the just social order, establish justice and fair play, and become witnesses for Allah. And let me quote here, you know, in the next surah, Suratul Maida, this subject will be repeated in a reverse order. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kunu qawwamina lillahi shuhada bil qist. So these things are interchangeable. قوامين بالقسط قوامين لله شهداء لله شهداء للقسط Allah is just and He loves justice. You establish justice, you become a witness for Allah. You become a witness for Allah, then you have to establish His just social order that He has given for humanity. So you may say either from this side or that side. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء لله يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين لله شهداء بالقسط The same ayah repeated in these two surahs and they go to make a pair I told you Surah Al-Nisa, Surah Al-Maida and this is a common ayah between the two Now if you are saying something which is just maybe it is going against you now you'll hesitate Maybe it is going against your parents. Again, a hesitation. So this is the verse. وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوِلْ وَالِدَيْنِ أَوِلْ أَقْرَبِينَ You have to do justice. You have to say whatever is just and correct. Let it be against your own self. Or against your parents. Or against your relatives. Against your nation. Against your party. If your party leader is doing something wrong, you should be able to stand up and say it is wrong. وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوِلْ وَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ إِنْ يَكُنْ غَنِيًّا وَنُفَقِيرًا فَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ بِهِمَا If your parents are poor, if your relatives are poor, or if they are wealthy, well, it is irrelevant. Allah is closer to them than you. Whether He is poor or rich. Don't think because, you know, my relative is poor. In this case, if I do something unjust, but it helps him, it's good. No. No injustice in any way. Whether he is poor or he is rich. You have to decide justly. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Now just look. This is the teaching of Islam. Where are we? We can't say some truth. If it goes against my own self, or my parents, or my family, or my party, or my something else. Partisanship. I have to say in favor of my party. I have to say in favor of my tribe. I have to remain anyhow in favor of my family. No. The teaching of Quran is, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kunu qawwamina bilqisti shuhada lillah. Walau ala anfusikum ma bilwalidayni walakrabin. إن يكن غنيا أو فقيرا فالله أعلى بهما فلا تتبعوا الهوى أن تعدلوا don't follow your lusts your desires your vain desires of your id or libido lest they should take you away from عدل أن تعدلوا وإن تلووا أو تعرضوا if you twist now this twisty can be of the tongue saying something but twisting it you don't want to say it correctly Because it is going against yourself or against your parents or against your family. وَتَلْوُوا أَوْ تُعْرِضُوا. Or you just want to ignore it. You want just to refrain from it. You don't want to testify. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا. Don't think that Allah is unaware of what you are doing. He knows you through and through. He sees you through and through. Now this is the final ayah in this surah, a long passage which was there for the Muslim. Now again, the subject of nifaq and munafiqeen. And a very profound ayah, very important. The ayah, the only ayah of its kind in the whole of Quran. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا آمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالْكِتَابِ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِهِ وَالْكِتَابِ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. O you who believe, have real belief in Allah and His Messenger. It's very strange. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا آمِنُوا. You have accepted Him or them as Mu'mins. You are addressing them. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And then you are saying to them, have faith. In the background are munafiqeen. You profess to be mu'min, you are not mu'min. But it applies to us also. We profess to be mu'mins, but we are only Muslims. And that also due to the accident of birth. Because accidentally we were born of Muslim parents, that's all. What we think is iman is not iman. It's a dogma, a racial creed, a set of dogma, not conviction. So generalized way also, this ayah is very important. In the context, munafiqeen, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا آمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالْكِتَابِ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِهِ وَالْكِتَابِ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. Oh, you who believe, have real faith, real belief, real conviction in Allah and His Messenger, and on the book that He has sent down on His Abd, ala Rasulihi, on His Messenger, and the book that He sent before. Very important, this ayah being revealed, maybe it is in the fifth year after Hijrah, but Allah Ta'ala is emphasizing iman on the books that we sent before also. And we people have just ignored. Do we read Torah? Do we ever read Bible? No doubt, the texts have been corrupted. But it doesn't mean that 100% has been corrupted. But what the Quran says? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا آمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالْكِتَابِ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِهِ وَالْكِتَابِ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ مِنْ قَبْلِ وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُولِهِ. Now here kufr is not the legal kufr, you know. Please understand two things. Legal iman, legal kufr. Real iman, real kufr, something else. We are legal mu'min. But are we real mu'mins? No. Maybe really we are kafirs. Buton se tujhko umeedin khuda se na umeedi, mujhe bata to sahi aur kafri kya hai. You have all the faith in matter, money. How much faith you have in Allah? Buton se tujhko umeed hai, khuda se na umeed hai. Mujhe bata to sahi, aur kafri kya hai? So real iman versus real kufr. Legal iman versus legal kufr. Who are the munafiqeen? Legally mu'min. Really kafir. Understand? They were legally Muslims. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the janaza prayer of even Abdullah ibn Ubay. Didn't he? He accepted him as a legal Muslim to his last. But he was the Raisul Munafiqeen. So this legal status is something else. And real status is something else. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا آمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالْكِتَابِ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِهِ وَالْكِتَابِ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ مِنْ قَبْلِ وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِاللَّهِ. Now we should peep down into our own hearts. Do we really believe in Allah, His existence? his attributes? Do I really feel he's seeing me? I am in his presence. Do I really believe in the existence of angels? Am I convinced about his books? Kutubihi, all the books. Rusulihi, all the messengers. Wal yawm al akhir, and the last day. Whosoever denies them, rejects them, doesn't have faith in them, doesn't have real belief in them, faqad dhalla dhalalan ba'ida. He has gone far astray, very far off from the right path. Now comes the most beautiful ayah of this subject. And I quoted it last night also. A munafiq is oscillating under a legal veneer of Islam. He remains a legal Muslim. But inside, within his personality, he is oscillating. Sometimes towards Iman, to the right side. And then he's going towards the left side. Towards Kufr, when there is some testing, some demand, come and go to war for the cause of Allah, now he's near Kufr. But if the conditions are okay, well, he will go to the mosque, he will pray behind the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is very near Iman today. So, oscillating between Iman and Kufr. What will happen? Either finally one settles to the right side, he becomes a real mu'min. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, aminu billahi wa rasooli. Or he, after oscillating for some time, then he settles to the left. He becomes min ashabi shimal. He becomes the leftist. He becomes the munafiq. And who is a munafiq? Inside kafir, outside Muslim. Now read the ayah. Inna allazina amanu, summa kafaru, summa amanu, summa kafaru, summa zdadu kufran. And the best simile of a person is who is drowning. Goes down deep into water, then comes up. Then goes down, then comes up. A few, movements up and down, and then he goes down. In the same way, inna allazina amanu, summa kafaru, summa amanu, summa kafaru, summa zdadu kufran. Now they have nifaq established in their hearts. Lam yakunillahu liyaghfira lahum wala liyahdiyahum sabila. Allah is not going to pardon them, nor to show them any path. All the paths towards right, towards justice, towards salvation are closed for them now. Bashiril munafiqeen. Now here, the secret has been disclosed. Who were these people about with whom this discussion was? Bashiril munafiqeen bi anna lahum azaban aleema. This was not the legal Islam or legal kufr which was being discussed in these ayat. It was the real kufr. Legal Islam, real kufr, that is nifaq. Bashiril munafiqeen bi anna lahum azaban aleema. Oh messenger, oh Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give these munafiqeen the glad tidings. Glad tidings of what? That for them there is a very painful punishment, painful chastisement. Inna allazeena yattakhidun al-kafirin awliya. Now another sign of munafiqeen. They used to make friends with the Jews. Because, a struggle is going on. You can't say which way the wind will blow, finally. So don't be hasty in taking sides. You must keep something, some goodwill with these people also. Maybe that they become victorious. Don't keep all your eggs in one basket. You should be intelligent enough. So maintain some relations this side also, that side also. This is it. Inna alladhina yattakhidun al-kafirina awliya min dunil mu'minin. Verily those who take the kuffar, the unbelievers, as protectors and friends instead of the mu'mins, ayabtahuna indahumul izzah, are they trying to get from them the honor? They are seeking honor from them? Because these tribes are very strong. They have very big strongholds in Medina. So we should have some good offices with them. Ayabtahuna indahumul izzah. فَإِنَّ الْعِزَّةَ لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا. They should know that honor belongs to Allah totally. وَقَدْ نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ. And he has already sent down upon you the ayah. Now here, it's the reference to ayah number 68 of Surah Al-An'am. Because that was Makki, it had already been revealed. And that ayah is that if you find people mocking at Quran, and you know, then you don't sit with them. Leave them. But be watchful when they have done away with this attitude, and they are talking about something else, then you can come. So that you have to invite them. You can't leave them altogether. But when they are mocking at Quran or Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you remain there, what does it prove? Aap beghairat hai iska matlab hai. You don't have any sincerity towards Muhammad and Quran sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that ayah that is being referred to here, وَلَقَدْ نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا وَيُسْتَحْزَعُ بِهَا. It has already been sent upon you. That is in ayah 68 of Surah Al-An'am. أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ. That when you hear آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا, that the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ayat of Quran, they are being rejected and mocked upon. وَيُسْتَحْزَعُ بِهَا فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ. Don't sit with them now. You leave that place in protest. That is the least that you should do. حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ. Till such time that they are engaged in some other topic now. Then you can come and join them. إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِسْلَهُمْ. If you keep sitting with them in their society when they are laughing at Muhammad, mocking at Muhammad, mocking at Quran sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِسْلَهُمْ. Then you become also like them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَامِعُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْكَافِرِينَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ جَمِيعًا. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather together the munafiqeen and kuffar fi jahannam, in the hell. And here in this world, munafiqeen are with Muslims. They are also legal Muslims. In the hereafter, they will be with the kuffar. Clear? In this world, they are intermixed with Muslims. They are praying behind Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the mosque. They are a part and parcel of the Muslim society. But in the hereafter, they will be bracketed with the unbelievers. إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَامِعُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْكَافِرِينَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ جَمِيعًا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَرَبَّصُونَ بِكُمْ. Who are those munafiqeen? They are waiting for you. Wait and see which way the wind blows. Tail dekho, tail ki dhaar dekho. Don't take sides. يَتَرَبَّصُونَ بِكُمْ فَإِنْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فَتْحٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ. If a victory comes to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's grace and bounty, قَالُوا أَلَمْ نَكُمْ مَعَكُمْ. They will come, oh, we were also with you. Were we not with you? We were Muslims. Were we not praying behind the messenger of Allah? So that we should have also a part in the booty, in the gains. وَإِنْ كَانَ لِلْكَافِرِينَ نَصِيبٌ. And if you know there is some good luck for the kuffar, for the unbelievers, قَالُوا أَلَمْ نَسْتَحْوِذْ عَلَيْكُمْ وَنَمْنَعْكُمْ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. They will go to the kuffar and say, didn't we provide you with a covering? And we protected you from the Muslims. Because they had relations with Jews also. Telling them the news. Now this is being decided. Okay, I told you at that time. And I, you know, conveyed to you that secret of Muslims. So now, I am with you. If you are victorious, I am with you. This is their mentality. This oscillation. Double-mindedness, double-facedness. They have two faces. وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِذَا شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. I don't remember. إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَهْزِئُونَ. Allahu yastazi'u bihim wa yamudduhum fi tughyanihim ya'mahun. الذين يتربصون بكم فإن كان لكم فتح من الله قالوا لم نكن معكم وإن كان للكافرين نصيب قالوا لم نستحوذ عليكم ونمنعكم من المؤمنين فالله يحكم بينكم يوم القيامة. Allah will decide between you on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection. ولن يجعل الله للكافرين على المؤمنين سبيلا. And in this world also Allah is not going to give these unbelievers any way over the moments, over the believers. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ. These munafiqeen, these hypocrites, they are trying to deceive Allah. يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ. In the very beginning, in the second ruku of Surah Al-Baqarah. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهِ. They want to deceive Allah. وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is letting them go in deception. He is يَمُدُّهُمْ فِي تُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ, giving them the respite, stretching the rope for them. Let them go to any extent. Let them go to any extent so that they can prove whatever evil was hidden in their minds and hearts. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى. When they stand up for prayer, they stand very lazily, reluctantly. They don't have the love for Allah. They don't go with hearty inclination. But because they have to show off to the Muslims that we are also Muslims. They have to prove, because at that time nobody could be accepted as a Muslim if he doesn't pray. So the worst of the munafiqs also had to pray 5 times a day. But actually they were not praying from their own depths of their hearts. It was only to show off, and that is the word coming next. وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى صَلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى يُرَاؤُونَ لِلنَّاسِ. يُرَاؤُونَ لِلنَّاسِ. They are showing off for the people to be counted as Muslims. وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And they don't actually remember Allah, but very little, except very little. Maybe at some time when they have stood behind Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, some flash of lightning comes to them, maybe. After all, Muhammad is leading the prayer. Maybe some, you know, ray of light, it shines for them also. Illa qalila. But actually, they have joined the congregation only to show to the people so that they can be counted as Muslims. They can be accepted as Muslims, at least legally. Muzabzabina bayna zalik. Now the word. They have become double-minded, wavering. Muzabzabina bayna zalik. Oscillating. Now oscillation towards this side and then to this side. But actually, neither to this side nor to this side. If you are to this side, then you don't go to the other side. If you are sincere to the other side, then you never come to this side. When you are oscillating, you are sincere to neither this side nor that side. مُزَبْزَبِينَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ لَا إِلَهَا أُولَاءِ وَلَا إِلَهَا أُولَاءِ. Actually, they are neither with them nor with them. They are neither with Muslims nor with the Jews or the Kuffar. They are sincere to none. When they are not sincere to Allah, how can be sincere to anybody else? Had they been sincere to Allah, they would have been the true Muslim Mu'mins. One is not sincere to Allah, how can he be sincere to anybody else? Maybe they are Muslims or they are Kuffar. They are none. Sincere to none. مُزَبْزَبِينَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ لَا إِلَهَا أُولَاءِ وَلَا إِلَهَا أُولَاءِ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَلَنْ تَجِدَ لَهُ سَبِيلًا. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared as gone astray. Allah doesn't lead anybody astray. Doesn't turn the direction of anybody towards wrong direction forcibly. But whosoever chooses a wrong direction, he allows him to go that way. And when you know he has reached a point which we call point of no return, then Allah puts a seal, okay, go. Go to hell now. And now, after this point, if you want to bring him back to the right path, you can't do it. Allah has already put the seal. مُذَبَّبِينَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ لَا إِلَهَا أُولَاءِ وَلَا إِلَهَا أُولَاءِ وَمَنْ يُرْضِ اللَّهُ فَلَنْ تَجِدَ لَهُ سَبِيلًا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّخِذُوا الْكَافِرِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ. Oh, you who believe, don't take the unbelievers as friends. مِنْ دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, instead of mu'mins. أَتُرِيدُونَ أَنْ تَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ سُلْطَانًا مُبِينًا. Do you want to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a clear charge against you? If you make friend with kuffar, with unbelievers, with the enemies of Allah, with the enemies of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who have rejected faith, you are making friends with them. You love them. This will become the biggest charge against you on the day of judgment. How come? You profess to believe in me and believe in Muhammad, and you are behaving friendly towards the enemies of Allah and enemies of Muhammad. This will be a clear charge against you. أَتُرِيدُونَ أَن تَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ سُلْطَانًا مُبِينًا إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. These hypocrites will be in the lowest part of hell. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes nifaq more than kufr. He hates nifaq more than kufr. That is why he is hating the Muslim Ummah today. And he has given authority, power, respect to kuffar. At least they don't profess to believe in me. Look to them, they believe in me. They pray to me. And then they go out and do business on interest. They say they believe in Quran. And then they are not accepting the commands of Quran. This is worse than kufr. Allah is not cruel. وَمَا أَنَا بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ. I am not cruel to my creatures, to my servants, my bondsmen. How come? There is something. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ وَلَنْ تَجَدَ لَهُمْ نَصِيرًا. These hypocrites will be the lowest part of the fire, of hell. And you will not be able to find any helper for them. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا. But still there is time to mend. Because it is nearly the middle of the Madani period. 5th year or 6th year, it's the middle of the Madani period. When you know, it was about 9th year after Hijrah, nearly the end of the Madani period, and nearly the end of the this worldly life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the doors of Tawbah were closed for munafiqeen. But here still, the doors have been kept open for them. You can still mend your ways. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا. Except those who turn to Allah, return to Allah. Who repent, وَأَصْلَحُوا, they mend their ways. وَأَتَصَمُوا بِاللَّهِ, and now they hold fast to Allah, cling to Allah. Cling to His deen, cling to His rope, and that rope is Qur'an. وَأَخْلَصُوا دِينَهُمْ, and they have made their deen pure and sincerely for Allah. Nothing else. فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Such people will be included among the real believers. The gate of Tawbah are still open. There's a very beautiful couplet in Persian. Darhae Firdos Wabud Imroz Az Be Niyazi Guftem Farda. Today the gates of paradise were open. I could go to paradise today. What does it mean? I could make Tawbah today. Darhae Firdos Wabud Imroz Az Be Niyazi Guftem Farda We said, no, 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 no. I shall enter tomorrow, and tomorrow never comes. So make the best use of time, the chance that you are getting. You can't be sure you can have another life, an year in life. But you are planning. And you are differing deen. Let me do this first, and then, you know, I'll do. I'll, you know, fully devote to religion and deen, and the qamat deen, and the ihya'i deen. But presently I'm engaged in this and this and this and this. As if you are sure. And who is sure that he will be able to see the sun tomorrow? And if anybody is sure, he's a fool. So that is it. Ta'khir. Darhai firdaus wabud imroz. Today. Az benayadi guftem farda. إلا الذين تابوا وأصلحوا واعتصموا بالله وأخلصوا دينهم لله فأولئك مع المؤمنين وسوف يؤتي الله المؤمنين أجرا عظيما. And soon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the believers a very great reward. Again, you know, a very appealing mode of expression. Very appealing. ما يفعل الله بعذابكم. What will Allah do to punish you? Why will He punish you? Is he a sadist? Will he take pleasure in punishing you? No. But it is your deeds. It is what you have earned. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا حَلِيمًا. If you are grateful to Allah, if you are thankful to Allah, and if you have faith in Him, if you believe Him, what will He do? He doesn't like to put you in the fire of hell. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا. Allah is very much appreciative of any good that you do. And He is all-knowing. لَا يُحِبُّ اللَّهُ الْجَهْرَ بِالسُّوءِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ إِلَّا مَنْ ظُلِمْ. These two ayat now, following two ayat, are very important in a society. You know, in a society it often happens, somebody does some injustice to another man, some brother doing some injustice to a brother. إِنَّ الْخُلَطَى لَيَبْغِي بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ. Now, if a person has been wronged, injustice has been done to him, if he says out something loudly which is not pleasant or bad, although Allah doesn't like these things, but this person will be condoned and pardoned because he was wronged. Dukhe dil ki sada. Even he has used harsh words, bad words, ugly words, Allah will condone because he was wronged. La yuhibbu Allahu al-jahra bisu. Allah doesn't like shouting of bad words. Min al-qawl illa man zulim. Except from a person who has been wronged. Something harmful has been done to him. Either his honor or his life or his property or his body. Some injury has been done to it. Now if he says something, he will be condoned. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ سَمِيعًا عَلِيمًا. It's a very balanced teaching. Not only idealistic. Never say anything bad. It's very easy to say these words. But when you are in such a condition, you know, what will happen to you? تَا دِلَي صَاحِبْ دِلَي نَامَدْ بِدَرْدْ. هیچ قومِ را خدا رسوا نہ کرد. This honor comes to nations. Why? Because the hearts of some people who have iman in it, they feel pain. They are persecuted. تَا دِلَي صَاحِبْ دِلَي نَامَدْ بِدَرْدْ. هیچ قومی را خدا کو رسوا نہ کر دو. Don't inflict pain on any human being. Don't injure his honor or property or body. لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء من القول الا من ظلم فكان الله سميعا عليما. Allah is ever listening, ever all knowing. ان تبدو خيرا او تخفوه وتعفو عن سوء. But now this is the persuasion, targhib. First was concession. If something wrong has been done to you and you have said something ugly, you shouldn't have said so, but because you were wronged, okay, we shall pardon. But it is better for you not to say so. وَإِن تُبْدُوا خَيْرًا أَوْ تَخْفُوا. If you do good, either openly or secretly, أَوْ تَعْفُوا عَنْ سُوءٍ. Or if you forgive something which has been done to you bad, تَعْفُوا عَنْ سُوءٍ. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَفُوًا قَدِيرًا. So Allah is also forgiving. Don't you need His forgiveness? If you want His forgiveness, try to forgive your fellow brothers, your fellow beings. مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمْ لَا يُرْحَمْ. Al-Hadith. Who doesn't have mercy on men will not be able to get mercy from Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَفُوًا قَدِيرًا. He's Qadir. He can punish instantly. But He gives you time to amend your ways. He ignores. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْفُرُونَ. Again, three ayat are very important, very important, very important regarding a big fitna of our time. What is that fitna? Well, Qur'an is sufficient for us. Or, number two fitna. Well, if anybody belonging to any religion, if he has faith in Allah and resurrection and he does good deeds, well, he will have salvation. It's no need that he must be a Muslim. He must believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After all, he's a gentle person. He's a noble man. He established such a big foundation for the good of humanity, for the service of humanity. All these fitnas, you know, these three ayat will deal with it. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. Verily those who reject Allah and His apostles or messengers. وَيُرِيدُونَ يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. And they want to make a distinction between Allah and His messengers. Belief in Allah is sufficient. No need of belief in messengers. يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. They want to separate Allah from His messenger, or they want to separate His messengers from Allah. وَيَقُولُونَ نُؤْمِنُ بِبَعْضٍ وَنَكْفُرُ بِبَعْضٍ. And they say, we accept part of it, accept and reject the other. We accept Allah, but not the apostle. Or we accept one apostle, not the other. Both are equally wrong. وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن يَتَّخِذُوا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ سَبِيلًا. They want to have a middle path. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ حَقًّا. They are the unbelievers. In truth, they are unbelievers. وَعَتَدْنَا لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا. And we have prepared for such unbelievers and rejectors of the truth a chastisement which is very painful and very humiliating. On the contrary, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُولِهِ وَلَّمْ يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ. Now this is the positive side. Verily those who believe in Allah and His apostles and messengers and don't make any discrimination between them, between any of them, they accept Moses, they accept David, Solomon, says everyone, not Jesus, gone. They accept Jesus, not Muhammad, gone. Tafriq bain al-rusul. That is why we find, you know, in the last but one ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah, La nufarriqu bain ahadin min. آمن الرسول بما انزل اليه من ربه والمؤمنون كلنا آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين احد منهم ونحن له مسلمون نحن له مسلمون من رسله yes منهم that is in the 16th section of Surah Al-Baqarah. So we don't make any discrimination. We believe all the messengers of Allah. And very soon there will come an ayah that not only those apostles and prophets who have been mentioned in Quran, there have been many more. But we can't say for a particular person that he was an apostle or a messenger or a prophet of Allah unless his name has been mentioned in the Quran. We can't say it for sure. But we can say it for sure that so many other apostles and prophets of Allah were sent to this world who have not been mentioned in this Quran. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَلَمْ يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ أُولَٰئِكَ سَوْفَ يُؤْتِيهِمْ أُجُورَهُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. To these Allah will give them their reward, their due. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And Allah is ever forgiving, ever merciful. Now the seventh part of this surah, again to Ahl al-Kitab. يَسْأَلُكَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ أَن تُنَزِّلَ عَلَيْهِمْ كِتَابًا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَقَدْ سَأَلُوا مُوسَى أَكْبَرَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. But here you'll find that mostly the Ahl al-Kitab, the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians, mostly they are not addressed directly, indirect references, mentioning of their crimes, their misdeeds, their breaking of the covenants. As I told you, the charge sheet against them. Because on the basis of that charge sheet, they were deposed from that position that they held for 2,000 long years. يَسْأَلُكَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ أَن تُنَزِّلَ عَلَيْهِمْ كِتَابًا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these people of the book, they are demanding from you that you should make a book descend on them from the heavens, from the sky. What does it mean? They wanted a miracle. Well, the book Torah was given to Moses, full book, written form, on the tablets, stone tablets, and he brought down it from the heights of Tur. In the same way, if you are a messenger of Allah, you should also bring a book. Why is that book in written form? You have not brought it. It is coming to you according to your claim, bit by bit, bit by bit. يَسْأَلُكَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ أَن تُنَزِّلَ عَلَيْهِمْ كِتَابًا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَقَدْ سَأَلُوا مُوسَى أَكْبَرَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. They are accustomed to it. They had demanded from Moses more than that. فَقَالُوا أَرَنَا اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً. They had demanded from Moses, show us Allah very openly and plainly. We are not going to believe in you that you have been talking to Allah unless you can show us Allah. أَرَنَا اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً فَأَخَذَتْهُمُ السَّاعِقَةُ بِظُلْمِهِمْ. A thunderbolt seized them due to their misdeed. ثُمَّ اتَّخَذُوا الْعِجْلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. Then these are the people who took to the worship of Kaf after all the miracles were seen by them. They had seen all these 9 miracles of Moses alayhi salatu wasalam. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَىٰ تِسْعَ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ. Those miracles were seen by the Egyptians, the Firaun, and the people of the Firaun, but as well as by the Bani Israel. Even after seeing all those miracles, they took to the worship of Kaf. So what can a miracle do to them? What benefit can a miracle give to them? فَعَفَوْنَا عَنْ ذَلِكَ. Even after that, we pardoned them. وَآتَيْنَا مُوسَىٰ سُلْطَانًا مُبِينًا. And we gave Moses clear authority. وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَهُمُ الطُّورَ بِمِيثَاقِهِمْ. Now it's a big list, you know. These things have been discussed in detail in Surah Al-Baqarah. And we raised the mountain of Tur over their heads when we were taking the covenant from them. وَقُلْنَا لَهُمُ ادْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا. And we said to them, enter this gate, but in a humility, with a humility, bowing your heads. As far as the Mufassirin have thought, this is Jericho, Ariha. That was the first city of Palestine which was conquered by the Jews, by Bani Israel, after the completion of those 40 years of wilderness. Yatihuna fil ard. After that, Arba'ina sana, then they entered Palestine, and the first city which fell to them was Ariha, Jericho. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't enter now, because whosoever is victorious, he enters the city arrogantly, with tall necks, you know. But you know, you are mu'mins, and Allah has given you this favor. Your head must be bowing down. وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَهُمُ الطُّورَ بِمِيثَاقِهِمْ وَقُلْنَا لَهُمُ ادْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا وَقُلْنَا لَهُمْ لَا تَعْدُوا فِي السَّبْتِ. And we have commanded to them, don't transgress and don't break the law of Sabbath. وَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُمْ مِيثَاقًا غَلِيظًا. And we extracted from them a very strong and solemn pledge, Misaq, covenant. Now the charge sheet begins. فَبِمَا نَقْزِهِمْ مِيثَاقَهُمْ. So because of their breaking of their covenant, وَكُفْرِهِمْ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. فَبِمَا will be added to everything now. And because of their thanklessness towards the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَقَتْلِهِمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. قَتْلِهِمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. And because of their killing and slaying the prophets of Allah, they killed John the Baptist, Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam. They killed Zakriya alayhi salatu wasalam. بِغَيْرِ حَقٍ, without any cause, without any reason. وَقَالِهِمْ قُلُوبُنَا غُلْفٌ. And because of their saying that our hearts are fortified, oh Muhammad, you cannot reach our hearts. قُلُوبُنَا غُلْفٌ. Our hearts are protected. Don't think your talk can have any effect on our hearts. Qulubuna ghulf. Bal la'anahumullah. Bal taba'a Allahu 'alayha. What they are calling as protected hearts, actually Allah has put a seal on these hearts. Bikufrihim, due to their unbelieving. Fala yu'minuna illa qalila. And yes, they will not be able to have iman now, except only a very few of them. وَبِكُفْرِهِمْ وَقَالِهِمْ عَلَىٰ مَرْيَمَ بُهْتَانًا عَظِيمًا. Another charge, very big charge. And due to their kufr and denial, and their uttering against Maryam, a very big false charge. What is it? Illicit relations with Joseph. They say that Jesus was born due to illicit relation, illegal. They were not still married. But they had the intercourse, and the result was Jesus. It's a very big, false charge. Buhtan azim. وَبِكُفْرِهِمْ وَقَالِهِمْ عَلَىٰ مَرْيَمَ بُهْتَانًا عَظِيمًا. A calumny. وَقَالِهِمْ, and due to their saying, إِنَّا قَتَلْنَا الْمَسِيحَ عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمْ. We killed Jesus, son of Mary. Al-Masih. Rasulullah. How come they are saying, they are claiming they killed a messenger of Allah? وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ. while actually they didn't kill him. وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ And they didn't crucify him. وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ But only a likeness of him was shown to them. The features of the person were changed to the features of Jesus. The Quran doesn't give the detail how it happened and when it happened, at what stage it happened. I mean, we don't find any details in the authentic ahadith also. But the Gospel of Barnabas, although these people don't accept it as a canonical gospel. Canonical gospels are only four. But there are 100 more gospels. They call them apocryphal. Apocryphal gospels. And one of them is Barnabas. And they accept Barnabas was one of the Hawariyin of Hazrat Isa. This is accepted. But they don't accept his gospel. And that gospel has told everything in detail. When you know Hazrat Isa, along with his companions, his Hawariyin, he was hiding in a garden. One of the Hawariyin, Judas Iscariot, he just left the place to inform the Jewish hierarchy, the biggest rabbi of Jerusalem, I can lead you to the arrest of Jesus. For 30 pieces of gold, he got the price. He brought the people along with him to the gate of the garden. He said, you stop here, I'll enter. Then whomsoever I call, O master, seize him, he will be Jesus. When he entered, his shape, his features were changed to that of Jesus. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do it. And four angels came through the roof of that small cell in that garden. And they took, lifted, alive, bodily as well as spiritually, both things. Wholesome Jesus lifted them to the sky, alive. This is the detail. Now, this person, he went out. And the other disciples who were sleeping, they got awoke. Now, because now the features were changed to that of Jesus, they said, oh, our master. And at that very moment, the police entered that garden and they caught him. He is the person. So according to the Gospel of Barnabas, it was Judas Iscariot who was crucified, not Jesus, son of Mary. But Quran or Hadith doesn't give us this detail. But one thing is for sure, he was not crucified, he was not killed. This is our belief, this is our Iman. And that is the only difference between us and Christians regarding the person of Jesus. We also believe he has been lifted alive to heaven. They also believe. The only difference is that they think that he was crucified, he died on the cross, then he was resurrected, and then he was lifted. And we say, no, he was not crucified, he was not slain, he was lifted alive directly to heaven. Then again we agree, he will return to earth before the end of this world. Christians will also, and we also believe, both. The second coming of Jesus is a common factor between Muslims and Christians. And you must emphasize it. This is the common point. I gave a lecture, you know, recently in Lahore. And now it has been translated into English and published. To Christians with love. And you know there's very great need that here in this society you propagate this idea. That much is in common between you and us regarding the person of Jesus. According to these Jews, he was a bastard. God forbid. According to us, he was the messenger of Allah. According to us, he was born without father. As the Christians believe, we also believe. They also believe in the biggest miracles of Jesus. We also believe in the miracles of Jesus. They also believe that he was lifted alive to the heaven. We also believe he was lifted alive to heaven. They also believe he will come again, and we also believe he will come again. And that time will be the domination of Islam, because Christianity will be finished. All Christians will embrace Islam, because Jesus will come and say, well, I was not crucified. You were under a wrong notion. Yaksuru salib wa yaqtalul khinzir. When he comes second time, he will break this cross. And this cross is the symbol of Christianity. That Jesus died on cross. Yaksuru salib, the prophet had said in a hadith, he will come and break this cross. All the stories with this cross will go. I was not crucified. The basic dogma will be done away with. And he will kill the khinzir. Yaqtulul khinzir. They have made it permissible to eat. While it was haram in all the sharias. And you know, the Jews don't take it. So the deviation that they have done, that deviation will be finished. And you know, Christianity will become Islam. And that will be the domination of Islam over the whole of the world. وَقَالَهِمْ إِنَّا قَتَلْنَا الْمَسِيحَ عِيسَى ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ لَفِي شَكٍّ مِّنْ. And verily those who are differing about him, was he killed or not? Was he slain or not? Was he resurrected or not? And now Ghulam Ahmad Qadiani said, well, he escaped, he ran away from there, he came to Kashmir and died here. All these ikhtilafat, you know. Inna alladheena ikhtalafu fihi lafi shakkin min. They are only conjecturing. These are all their fabrications of their own thinking and imagination. Ma lahum bihi min ilm illa ittiba'a dhann. They don't have any knowledge of it. They are only following conjectures and nothing else. وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا. For sure they didn't kill him. They couldn't kill him. Nobody can kill, or nobody has ever killed a messenger of Allah. Anbiya have been killed. Prophets can be killed, could be killed, not the messengers. That is why this ayah, these words, you know, they are actually with a sign of exclamation. وَقَالِهِمْ إِنَّا قَتَلْنَا الْمَسِيحَ عِيسَى ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. They can't say it Rasul Allah, because if they had accepted him to be Rasul of Allah, they wouldn't have crucified him. So this is actually from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look to them. They say, they claim that they killed a messenger of Allah. While the messenger of Allah can never be killed. Otherwise, you know, the Prophet says, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, La waditu an uqtala fi sabilillah, summa uhya, summa uqtala, summa uhya, summa uqtala. I very much love that I should be killed in the way of Allah. And then resurrected, then again killed, then resurrected. I want to taste the taste of this shahada, laying down life for the cause of Allah. But this desire of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could not be conceded. Allah not accepting the desire, not fulfilling the desire of his beloved Habib. Why? This is the rule. كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَأَغْلِبَنَّ عَنَا وَرُسُلِي. It's the decision of Allah. He has written it down that I and my messengers will always be triumphant. Whole nations will be done away with, but the messenger will be kept safe. Nuh, Hud, Saleh, Lut, Shu'ayb, all saved. And whole of their nations, because they denied them, rejected them, they were finished. Rasul cannot be killed. بَلْ رَفَاهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ وَقَالَ اللَّهُ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا. On the contrary, Allah lifted him to himself. And verily, Allah is all-powerful, all-wise. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر. The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzim.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.